everybody, welcome to Sunday Outside. This isn't outside, I know it isn't. Last week it was raining. I can handle a bit of rain. Precipitation protection device, you're fine. A bit gusty this week though, and the tripod wobbling around everywhere when it gets blown over and I'm trying to catch it. It's actually quite stable, but it's a little too short. If it went to about 6 foot, it'd be great, but it doesn't. I think it stops at about something else. I don't know the metric of it, funny enough, I know. But that sort of thing was sold. I think it's American. I'm going to read your comments as well off the telly. Because it's easier than using that silly Amazon Fire thing, which is just getting worse and worse as the weeks go by. And let's read your comments from last Sunday outside. User J3ZJ2CI8L has put, "Hello dear, good to see you here. Many congratulations on reaching 10k subscribers. Booyakasha. Thank you, thanking you for making me laugh, and thanks for all the..." Oh, I don't even know how to work my own telly. Oh, flipping heck, hang on a sec. I need to click into the comment. "And thanks for the inquiry videos. Glad you're keeping it in the spotlight and putting the media to shame. Happy St. Patrick's Day. Blessing to all." I think I need glasses, you know. Well, I'm not. It's this eye here. It's never been the same since I got the Wahoo flu. And as I'm looking at you now, this eye here, it's got like a wave at the top and a wave at the side. My eyes used to be all right, and then since the Wahoo flu, it's never been the same. Is it connected? Is it just a coincidence? Don't know. And the next one, I think it was from the same comment, which I don't normally do, but there's only 13 comments last Sunday outside. "Yes, 100% agree with all the witnesses should be at the hearing unless weather or health generally prevents them. One of the former help desk witnesses came from mainland Europe, and there were real nuggets for your videos and speech bubbles. Cheers, my dears." Yes, I am doing obviously quite a lot of those videos because they are doing quite well. But the main point really is because I'm just so insensitive how they've been treated, these people, and just that the media are still just sidelining this story. It's ridiculous. The biggest UK scam. You know, it's ridiculous. Janet Holmes has put, "You deserve all the subs and many more. Your commentary is hilarious, furious and informative." Love it. Thank you very much. Flipping heck, it's really warm. This front room, I tell you, is ridiculously hot. It's like living in a greenhouse. And you know I hate the heat. I love the cold. I wore this very t-shirt in that snowy part of the titles, which I put in this video. And it's too hot. And Mr. Dan Giles, 90, has put, "Well done on 10k, my fellow Yorkshireman." Thank you very much. "Congrats on 10k subscribers," put DJ Donnelly. Sonia has put, "Congratulations on 10k subscribers, Charlie. You have a new job. Where you're working in a theatre." No, I'm not working in a theatre. I'm just a receptionist. Not a fancy one, though. I don't have a, like, microphone. I'm not, like... Oh, I was trying to use that as the microphone. I usually use a straw. I'm not like, "Please hold." I'm not like that. And EJ3ZJ2CIAL. This is like an eye test right here. I was put, "Jeremy Dangerous Name Hunt." Yeah. "What I'm eating you, Kate's put, I thought you said Sherlock was 60 and 20, and then I was just about to say, oh my god, it looks good for 80, but then realised you said 60 and plenty. And Monday greetings from Birdseer again. Well, I've just finished listening to Dave Posnett's interviews from December 2023 on the Post Office scandal. Ad infuriatum. It's another damning witness statement following the how Post Office Limited, Fujitsu and the security investigation teams, especially John Scott, operated behind closed doors. It appears that Scott's bully boy attitude and tactics have now been confirmed. Frustratingly, there were lots of interruptions because of the construction work going on outside and the inquiry room. How annoying. Given the several repeated interruptions, one can only begin for the entertaining notions of conspiracy to pervert the course of justice, or the course of the inquiry. Either that or there is an utter moron in charge of the nearby construction site. And that's since when do construction sites actually see them being constructed on? I mean, usually it's just like loads of laying around bollards and barriers, isn't it? This interview gave me some deep insights into the workings of Post Office Limited investigations and security teams and other operators behind closed doors, which included the lack of coming next, and it's only halfway through the inquiry. It's a big pain in the backside, isn't it? Because this inquiry is dragging on, and it's mainly because the witnesses, are just saying, can't remember, I don't know. And I have had a few comments of people saying, oh, it is hard to remember that long ago. And it's like, well, Jason Beer even says in one of the videos that he did 1,400 investigations. You were asked about what you did. You can't say you can't remember. You might not be able to remember a lot of the specific ones, but the general course of the job, you would remember. I can still remember what I used to do at Argos, and that was 20 years ago. I can still remember the fundamental parts of the job. Working on the tills, I would have to take the catalogue number off the little slip, which people would write in pencil, which sometimes they would get wrong because it flip numbers around, and then you've got to try and figure it out. And then you've got to flick through the catalogue to find the right number, unless it was something very common, which you still learn numbers on. I've still got numbers in my head, for instance. It's been 20 years and I still know catalogue numbers. 980-0971 is an Energizer square battery. Why do we know this information? It's been 20 years since I left Argos. I think I left Argos in 2003. Another catalogue I remember is 553-4049. It's either 553 or 533-4049, which at the time was the cheapest DVD player you could buy, because it was the first DVD player that went under 50 quid, and everyone was coming to Argos to buy this new DVD player. And then the thing was, that catalogue number, you could end up with one or two different DVD players. It was either the really cheap basic Alba one, or you'd get the Acoustic Solutions one, which was a little bit fancier looking, a little bit classier looking, but fundamentally the same sort of thing. And it was just very cheap DVD players. See, I can remember stuff like that. You do remember stuff from 20 years ago. I can remember working on collection. I can remember there was three different colours of carrier bag. The little small blue ones was mainly for jewellery and little small items. Then you had the green carrier bags, which were a little bit bigger than medium bags. Then you had the big bags, the yellow ones. And it was Argos Brighter Shopping. There you are, 20 years ago. I ain't going to say all what I did there. I worked there for about a couple of years. And I remember all sorts. Catalogue numbers. I remember more catalogue numbers. I remember all sorts. So it's ridiculous to say I can't remember anything at all about the job when she did 1,400 investigations. Don't believe her. Shane Ollis, but hello Charlie, your fatigue sounds quite difficult to deal with. I've been for a health check and I got some blood tests done. I don't know if I will know the results before Sunday outside, because it might take a week. I am extremely nervous about it. I almost regret it. However, I guess tests are important. I guess there is always a sense of concern that my life might change forever and not in a positive way. On Friday, the doctor wants me to book a routine appointment. I'm worried now. I'm assuming my tiredness is a symptom of something. I'm sure you'll be fine, Shane. The worst thing you can do is worry. Worrying will just wear you out even more. It's flipping boiling in this flat. Try not to worry. I know it's easy to say try not to worry. If you stop worrying, you'll feel a lot better. It's very easy to say that when you're not the person yourself, but worrying can wear you out as well. You need to distract your mind with other things. User EJ3ZJ2CIAL, I think that's Bird Seer again, has put fudgy wudginess. I love the word fudgy wudginess. I'm sure we had it before it was mentioned on Black Books, but I love the word fudgy wudginess. Next video is probably going to be on the post office scam, isn't it? I've got an advert for Toffee Fee.
Hazelnut spread and chocolate. There's so much fun in Toffee Fee.
They don't do the jingle anymore! That's not the advert! That's like... not. Oh, what a disappointment for Sunday that was! I was expecting the jingle. There's so much fun in Toffee Fee. That's like having the Calgon advert without the stupid jingle for Calgon. Do you remember when the Smith the Calgon advert opened? It was ridiculous. Washing machines, love on, the Calgon. It's like, no, you can't speed it up. It's got to be the right rhythm and the right speed and temper. Washing machines live longer with Calgon. Like that. You can't have Toffifee without the Toffifee.
It's a story.
Oh, I need to turn this down now, don't I? Oh. Skip. Yes, right. We are on to the inquiry of Helen Rose with Jason Beer. And the comments are many, so I just flick through five at random. I've got Robert Newton, who said, "These people are complicit in destroying the lives of innocent people. They were ill-equipped and poorly trained for their jobs and for what they had to do. The post office, the post office board and the senior management should all be in the dock watching this. It's so just upset." Exactly, and that's got four likes, that comment. Absolutely. The fact that sometimes they're not even in the inquiry room is ridiculous. But there should be more people involved in that courtroom. They should be brought there because they need to know what these victims went through. Next one is STCO 2426. That's what, good work. Noted that the DPS computing is having snags with Google, so come in here. This is really disappointing because I wish there were more channels focused on this biggest UK scandal in history ever. Full stop. Because the fact that there's only me and a few others, and one of them is having a bit of trouble with Google and YouTube, is really disappointing because it's just going to stifle the news of it. And we need to keep it in the public's mind because the media are doing a really naff job of it. And Troyer E has put, "What a bunch of ghouls. They simply did not care who got gutted. It did not matter." I know, it's absolutely outrageous. By the way, if you don't read your comment out, all your comments are valid, and I've read your comments, all of them. I enjoy reading all your comments, but I just don't have the time to do it on Sunday outside. I've got to go to work. UK Dave 57 has put, "You are doing great work to keep this disgusting scam in the limelight. Thank you very much." Yes, but we can all do it. We can just keep mentioning it from time to time. You know, have conversations. Just keep it in your mind. Because there's one thing the post office, Fujitsu, and all the governments can't do is throw money at this and distract your own brain. The cat 1984 this out of our heads. We should remember this and what they're capable of. Annoying B Stard has put, It's interesting she's claiming as an auditor she made no decisions to prosecute and it was a decision of an investigator. Yeah, she became an investigator as well, didn't she? I'm looking forward to whom she blames during her later career when she was, in fact, an investigator. Well, yeah, that was in part 213. Absolutely outrageous behaviour. And two more comments. "I would love to know how much the post office paid this woman and how many bonuses she received over the years. I'd also like to know how many Christmas bashes, sherry parties and drinky poos gigs she attended at postmasters and postmistresses who are being wrongly convicted and banged up." Absolutely. I bet as well. I mean, that horrible attire she was wearing. She can have all the money in the world, but she has no taste. How dare she turn up to inquiry dressed like that? It was completely inappropriate. Contempt of court and contempt for the victims is the way I see it. And the last comment I'm going to read on this video is from Peter Kazmases has put, what strikes me from all of these inquiry sittings is the absolute very poor caliber of Post Office Limited employees at this level. None of the investigators," and that's in speech marks, seem to have any oomph to actually want to investigate anything. Exactly. They didn't even do the bare minimum. They just did nothing. It just seemed to be passing papers between them, didn't it, at the most. "I find it very hard to believe that these managers," in quotes again, "cannot recall much about the work they did." It doesn't make sense. I've just mentioned in the Sunday Outside from last week's comments, if you've already jumped ahead to these ones, is that I can remember very clearly jobs that I've done from 20 years ago. Argos, Boots, Sainsbury's. I can remember certain customer interactions. I might not be able to remember exact days they happened, but I can remember the fundamentals and significances and idiosyncrasies of the jobs that I had to do, where they were located. And yes, it's ridiculous from today. Like Jason Beer says, you've done 1,400 investigations. I'm sure you're going to remember exactly what you did because you did it 1,400 times. You didn't just teleport yourself into a post office. You know, you had to go there and you probably introduced yourself. You know, that sort of thing. It's like, how could you possibly have forgotten any of that? Doesn't make sense. I've got now some Get Pro yogurt products by some sports personality. As Joanna Lumley says, in absolutely fabulous contradiction in terms. And I've got a kayak advert. I've never done it like this before, and I've just realised I've got to watch the adverts to my own videos before I can actually get to the comments, because the video's got to start. Come on. Yes, kayak. Yes. Right, so part two of the inquiry. I'm going to read five random questions out. Again, once again, all your comments are valid. I do read them all, but I just can't read them all out on Sunday outside. And I did go through a phase of trying to like all the comments, but then I was thinking, oh no, I get really anxious because I'm thinking if someone doesn't say that I liked their comment, they're going to think that I don't like that comment. Why have they liked every other comment? And then I've thought, oh, that's just getting too confusing. Garrick Stephen 2 has put, do we get the full name when I click into the comment? No, we do not. Anyway, it's put, I've said before, and I make no apologies for saying it again. No apologies for saying it again. It was the other great British institution. The NHS is run by managers of a similar calibre to those managing the post office. No wonder it's in the state that it's in. Yes, it's really frustrating. One of the reasons, of many reasons, that I do these videos is because business incompetence really frustrates me. I've worked for so many companies and I've worked so hard. I really care about the jobs that I've had. But I have no chance of progressing because I work too hard. Now that might sound really self-entitled and self-full of myself and this, that and the other. But I do care. I've applied for a job to work in, to spend my time working for that company. But I just feel like I'm just shoved to the side or battered aside. Either because it's my voice, they don't like me. Don't care. If you don't like me, can't you just like the work that I do that I care? I've got excellent customer service. That's not me being full of myself. I do because I generally care about customer service. That might confuse some people in this country about good customer service in this country. It's unheard of. Well, it is heard of. I see it all the time. It just never gets commented on enough. It's very easy for people to complain, but it's really rare for people to give compliments on reviews, like on Google reviews or anything like that. So, you know. But you've got no chance when you've got a manager or a supervisor, area manager, whatever, who really couldn't care less. And they just want to just belittle you or just look at you up and down. Like, why does he enjoy his job? He's only working in a supermarket. He's only working in a shop. Because maybe I'm a people person. Maybe he didn't just blag my way through my job interview. Maybe I told the truth in my job interview. I like doing good customer service. I actually care about people. But it's just ridiculous because there's so many people that you'll work with who don't give a damn. And they'll just either be sleeping with the manager or supervisor to sleep the way to the top. Or we'll just somehow be just best buddies with them. And then they'll progress into, and then they'll change into this horrible supervisor or something. And they seem to get all the promotions and all the glory of your hard work. And I've just had enough. I've had enough. And the post office is a great symbolism of it. It's clearly people working at that head office who do not care about people. They didn't care about the customers because they were shutting post offices down. Post offices were getting closed down as a big two fingers up to the customers because it was obviously, it's bad what they were doing to the sub-postmasters. But the entire shop was closing down, not just the post office, the shop as well, which was obviously generally mostly profitable shops. That's why they were open. That's why we heard about Mrs. Hamilton with their shop and Seema Mishra. They all had profitable businesses because they were paying these losses to the post office. It just really bugs me that so many people's concentration of incompetence has destroyed so many lives. And I hate seeing injustice and incompetent people promoted beyond all of their ability. Really sets me off, as you can tell. Another comment. AW6936 has put, not for the first time, I'm struck by the fact that the witness, fumbling inarticulate, not that intelligent, is supposed to have created documents that are clearly beyond their competence to have written. Yes! It's like Janelle Singh is meant to be a lawyer. And his sentence structure and his grammar is appalling. Someone else writes all this stuff and they just sign them. No wonder they don't remember anything. I know, because they even had to get a different company, didn't they, at Cartwright King, to write some of these documents, because it was ridiculous. And they even said that Janelle Singh's way of writing was just too... Oh no, that was the public relations area of the post office, wasn't it? Even they thought his language was too wishy-washy. Ridiculous. And Bicops 2021 has put, I was waiting for the Elaine Cotton line. I don't even know why I'm here. I know, exactly, because it just fills you with so much rage. It does me. Don't you feel angry about this? I mean, I'm presuming that you work. Even if you don't work, if you've had to deal with any company ever, and it's clear that they don't know what they're doing, and you're thinking, how did you get this job? Is it just you, or is everyone you work with as dull and dim as you? And are you really that stupid? And oh, it just makes you want to tear your eyeballs out, squeeze them because you can't believe what you're seeing, rip out your eardrums and go, are you working? Stuff them all back in. And you'd open your eyes and your ears and you'd be like, yeah, they are really this dense. What can you do? Next comment from Trick1838 has put, thank you, Charlie, great work. Thank you very much. It's nice that you're coming, but it really, really is, but sometimes I'm very, very humbled is what I should say, because I never expected it to be as big as this for me. But I'm glad that the overarching thing, the biggest thing for me, is I'm glad I'm keeping this in people's minds, because by chaining together the most relevant parts, editing out the long, long gaps, and there's a lot of work involved because they have to watch it at least three times. And it's sometimes I can watch the same things 4 or 5 times over, and my brain just feels as if it's melting sometimes with the incompetence of some of these people. Colin Pike has put, I can now see why so many village post offices suddenly closed. Absolutely. Were post office doing it deliberately? Did they just not want to send out their vans and lorries to all these little villages everywhere because it was costing so much money? Is this what it's about? You know, is that the bigger question that needs to be asked? Were they doing it deliberately? Was it, who knows? Because who knows what's being shredded? Nicholas Turner has put, as they walk out the inquiry, or in this case, close down the computer, most of the peer witnesses should have been taken to a police station and charged. Absolutely. The only reason why I'd allow Paula Venables, Angela van den Burgert, and a few of the others, Janelle Singh, to appear by video link is because it's from their prison cell. You know, even if they've been just been held in an open prison, so they can't leave the country, because it's going to be ridiculous, because by the time any punishment comes, they're just going to jet off somewhere. Don't forget, Paula Venables got all the millions of pounds in bonuses. A couple of more comments. William Evans has put, in the Castleton case, to take just one example, when a sub-postmaster was suspended and replaced by an interim sub-postmaster, if a suspended member of staff had been responsible for losses, one would have expected these losses to cease as soon as the interim post was in post. Did this, in fact, occur, or did losses continue, even when a replacement sub-post officer? Furthermore, Who in daily speech uses the phrase, I can't recall? Absolutely. Rather than I don't remember. This is a common feature in many of the post office witnesses' oral statements. Coincidence or not, I wonder. Absolutely, because I can't recall seems to be used so much. They are all lawyered up. They've all gone out and got solicitors. Because we know that from Cotton as well, because she even said, picked up her solicitors file by, well, not accident or by mistake, but she mentioned the name of it when she was being interviewed by Jason Beer. And, yeah, I think that they're all just, like, proper legally, which they're entitled to do, you know. We don't live in that sort of country where you can't just pick somebody off the street, arrest them and throw them in prison, I don't think. But it's really obvious what they have sometimes, because saying I don't recall is very weird. Nobody says that in real life. I have never heard so much until I watched these inquiries. One last comment from the part two. From Cormorant has put, I feel Jason must have been aware of the time discrepancy given the emphasis on the time at 10:37 of the reversal in the log to the BT bill. I'm sure this will be pointed out in the inquiry final report. Jason's technique seems to make it clear as daylight when the witnesses contradict themselves, but he leaves out the final blow of actually saying they are lying. I assume, again, that the inquiry report will be more explicit in calling these people out. I assume there will be a string of perjury cases following this too. There must be. There has to be at least arrests or something like that for perverting the course of justice, because they've blatantly done it. They have done it. Jinal Singh has clearly done it because he's not done his job properly and stuff's been written to victim blame the supposed masters for stuff they've not done. You know, it's calling it the horizon bashing bandwagon. What a moron he was. Anyway, part three. Flipping heck, that was a long gab on that one. I didn't get an advert this time. I've got one of them quizzes, you know, the YouTube advertiser surveys. And it says, which of these hotels have you heard of? I have not heard of Ibra Star Hotels and Resorts, or Secret Resorts and Spas, Barcelo Hotels and Resorts, or TRS Hotels. And another at the bottom, it says none of the above, doesn't it? And the thing is, though, sometimes you do some of these surveys and it's you actually heard of all of them. So you click all of them and press submit, which means you've still achieved nothing because you've ticked them all. Anyway, comments for part three of... I've forgotten her name now because it's just so annoying. Helen Rose. Oh, dear me. Alistair Angus has put, Hare and Bradshaw, what a cruel and evil double act. Absolutely. Can you imagine having Hare and Stephen Bradshaw interviewing you? Bradshaw being really aggressive. And I bet she was as well. I bet she was like, chin down, eyebrows up, pursed lips. She's got that look about her. I bet she used to do that. Timothy Harris has put, Hannah Arendt's words about the banality of evil come to mind as I watch this incomparable person. Yes. It probably would have been better if I read that out properly, wouldn't it? Hannah, I don't even know the last name, how to pronounce it. Arendt's? Arendt's. D's and T's going together, just confusing. Words about banality of evil come to mind as I watch this contemptible person. Absolutely. DPS Computing, hello. As put, thank you, Charlie, for the shout out. I generally appreciate it. Absolutely solidarity and not competitors. Great vid as always. Thank you very much. I did say earlier in this video and on that video, I do not see people talking about this subject as rivals. We are all together in this, keeping it in people's minds, that we cannot let this be forgotten. We cannot let these people get away with clear perverting the course of justice. And at worst, obviously, leading to people ending of their living. I'm not wanting to say the word just because YouTube don't like me saying it. My nose itches when I'm angry, if you're wondering. And it's also a quick sweating in here as well. I'm boiling. Gary Up has put, everyone who works at the post office seems to have memory loss. Disgraceful. They need to be in court. I know, the amount of chronic amnesia is really frustrating and clearly orchestrated by themselves and their solicitors, lawyers, whatever. Really annoying. And even some of the other solicitors firms who are representing the sub-postmasters are saying, are these memory failures genuine? And I can't remember the other person said it wasn't just Helen Rose, they said it to somebody else as well. I can't remember if it was Elaine Cotton or somebody else, but they are getting annoyed. Red Pillar has put, I've been looking up Jason Beer, he's quite a high roller. When he's not doing inquiries, he's Deputy Crown Court Judge, as well as being head of his legal chambers. Yeah, I mean, clearly, if I'm ever accused of something I've not done, I want Jason Beer. The others are good as well. I know that I do focus a lot on Jason Beer, but it's just because some of the stuff it comes out with is quite funny. Because he's clearly calling these people out for the ridiculousness. The others don't do it as much. They are very to the point, which is very good, obviously. But I like Jason Beer's quips that he does. And his side eye that he does is really good. Another comment. How has the post office even managed to continue as a business, government-backed or otherwise, for so many years, and it seems to have the most senior managers and investigators all have symptoms of dementia, Alzheimer's, which, with each individual's memory being clearly severely impaired, it's a wonder that they can manage to remember their own names. There was a time when the fairness of the British justice system was a gold exemplar. This post office scandal shows just how far removed the post office has strayed from that standard. Apart from the post office senior staff being afflicted with global amnesia, it seems that there were also a post office-centred affliction of moral integrity and conscience. They all seem to be willing to throw each other under the bus to evade responsibility for their own actions. Thanks for your efforts and hard work to keep us abreast of what's going on, of the ongoing scandal proceedings. Keep up the good work. Thank you very much. That was Steve OBD 5901. It is hard work editing all these bits down. It really is. I love that everyone appreciates it. And everything you say, all your comments are just so good. I really wish I had the time, and I wish you had the time to listen to them all, because they're all so good. Andrew Gilbert has put, thank you. Thank you. Another comment, because that was too short. Jane Smith has put, thank you for the amazing videos. And Steviot has put, support DPS, great videos always. Thank you, Charlie, for this. An outrage here has put Cherry Rotella. Yes, I really hope the DPS computing thing gets sorted out very quickly. I know that it's been buffed aside for another 3 months, which is ridiculous, especially since we've got phase 5 and 6 starting before his channel gets reviewed again. Really frustrating. We don't need this kind of fudgy-wudginess going on at the moment. We need people to remember this forever, because there is going to be little news stories like, Kim Kardashian's got a new house, which the Daily Mail, the Sun and the Mirror are going to think are way more important. Who cares? And look how much everyone's regretted being nasty about Wills and Kate about the Photoshop picture. They're regretting that now, aren't they? I mean, I didn't actually care that it was Photoshopped. Who didn't do a bit of Photoshopping? I mean, I don't, because I can't. I don't have Photoshop. But, you know, if there's times, you know, if there's something in a thumbnail picture for a YouTube video that doesn't look quite right, I can delete it out using Microsoft Paint. Just erasing it. I don't have any fancy technology at all. But look what's happened. You know, people need to stop and think before they start typing away. They got all upset and offended over a picture that had been Photoshopped. And then there's this going on? Well, I hope they learned a flipping lesson. Anyway, that's the last of the post office videos for this week. Obviously, I've got my next one coming up for ABBA filming on Monday. The next video is Little Mermaid is 50, my reaction. Oh yeah, Little Mermaid's 50.
It's really annoying actually, because since I've been doing my Sunday outside today, inside,
adly a gust of wind outside. As soon as I want to do Sunday outside, it either starts blowing a gale, or it'll get really, really annoying weather-wise for some reason.
Very annoying. I forgot to click into the video.
Little Mermaid is 50. Oh, I've got an advert for Disney Plus. I think not. Go away. Oh good, I can skip it. Let's get to your comments. I don't know how many comments there is. There's only 8 comments, so I'll read all these ones out. The Bohemian put, I have no idea about Disney characters, but until the sad passing of Olivia Newton-John, I still wondered if Sandy and Danny would, if Sandy and Danny were still together and ever. Yeah, when they drove up into the sky in the car. User EJ3ZJ2CIAL, which is Boadicea, I remember now. Oh, Charlie, you are funny. So great and think outside the norm. I love it. Well, she was 16 years old in 1989-1990 in the Disney version of The Little Mermaid. So she would be 50 now. And wonder what she'd be doing. LGA857 has put 50 is the magic number. What's so magic about it? Mick Munn has put, funny you mentioned Sebastian. I saw him in a play a couple of months back. He has hit on hard times and the mermaid money has all gone on drugs and booze. He has underlining health issues. He said that he was typecast playing crab parts and didn't want that. Now he is living in a bedsit in Slough. You could see, you said all that and you didn't see us in a tight pinch. Oh, that's funny. Shane Hall has put, the middle-aged mermaid. Doesn't time fly? It is scary. You see, that is the follow-up that I would find hilarious. You know, Disney Plus is doing all this rehashed rubbish that no one wants to see. All the film companies are doing all these rubbish remakes, and I would be quite interested in the middle-aged mermaid. Okay, I would be quite interested to know if she's still happy. Up where they walk, up where they run, up where they stay all day in the sun. And I presume she isn't. It's a shame Ursula died in the film, because I think she'd have been great. And Jay Lady loads of other comments as well, but I only read out one comment if there's multiple comments. Let's move on to the last full-length video that I did this week, which was Air Fryer Friday. The Bohemian put, the JML version of an Afra exists. It's called a Go Chef. I clicked on a random shopping channel and landed upon the JML channel. An American man was shouting at me to buy one. Why do Americans need to shout when they're advertising stuff? Why can't it just, well, you see the English ones, don't you? You can tell when they've been remade English. Because it's just like, look at this new soup maker. But an American one would be like, get your soups in your home now! So. No. I'm not going to buy it, because you're shouting at me. An American man was shouting at me to buy one. I ignored him. As you do. Dolmio pizza, pasta sauce mattress, ran away. Ran away. I know, yeah, I always think of the Dolmio sauce or the Dolmio mattress. I'm thinking, why do you want your mattress to smell of Dolmio cooking sauce? It's very suspicious, very suspicious. Benjamin has put, love an air fry fry, David. And user EJ3ZJ2CIAL has put, hi Charlie, it's pronounced Arancini. Oh, I was calling it, what was I calling it? I can't remember what I was calling it now. It's an Italian rice bowl dish and they are delicious. And I first had them in Carluccio's. I'm guessing that two C's together is going to be an H, because that's generally what happens in Italian, isn't it? They always put a ch sound in where it doesn't belong. But then look at English. English language is brilliant. I love how confusing it is. Because I think things shouldn't be too easy to learn. In Carluccio's in Stratford-upon-Avon. Carluccio's. Yeah, it's Carluccio's, isn't it? Because there used to be one in Uxbridge. Yes. They were very delicious. And I'm definitely getting them again.
once the Italian Rangers returned to Lidl. And then we're moving on to the YouTube Shorts video. I did one and it was that double-ended bog brush. The double-ended bog brush. Red Pillar has put, there's bog brushes in Harrods worth £1,200. £1,200 to scrape away and keep the bog bowl clean. I was deeply offended when I saw that. £1,200 down the toilet, literally and metaphorically. Outrageous. Disgusting. You just get whatever cheap one. Well, I used to go to Wilkinson's to get a bog brush. You don't need to replace them that often, do you? And when you do, you just throw the whole thing away. I don't want to touch it. You know, once that thing's been used the first time down the toilet, I'm going nowhere near that unless I'm holding the handle, and that is it. The meme input, Christine uses one of these. Using this, you can cling two bagel bums at the same time. David Howe has put, it belongs in a modern art gallery. It's flipping disgusting. Anna Parry has put, I have no idea about the double-ended bog brush. You just put brush. How on earth can that work and not spray manky toilet water and more in your face when you move on to the second? I know, it's disgusting. Gunstaira, I love. I don't think I've seen your comment for a while. Has put, I would never ever want to use that. Neither would I. Shane Oles put, how vile. Ron Jim Zhang has put, I'm struggling to see if this video is a joke or not. Those are new brushes you can use to replace the used ones. You screw them loose, so that's two refills. And I put as a comment, because I replied to this one, I put, whenever a bog brush needs replacing, the full thing has gone in the bin. I don't want to touch the brush to replace it. And you don't, do you? I mean, looking at it now, and looking properly at it, I think what you're meant to do is unscrew one end so you've got a brush on a stick. But then you've got the loose one just hanging around. And that's just disgusting to look at because we all know where it's getting used for. You just have these hanging around. That's silly. LGA857 support. Whee! I've got a double-ended brush from IKEA. It's disgusting. Gary Bowman. Is it Bowman or Bowman? I've put his and hers. And that's all the comments. Thank you very much, everyone, for commenting. And let me know in the comment section down below anything you want to know. And I don't want to be able to reply to it because I don't know everything. I know nothing. As said in The Importance of Being Earnest. Yes. Do you know everything or do you know nothing? I know nothing. Because nobody knows everything, but it's very easy to know nothing. Like the post office headquarters and Fujitsu people. Anyway, thanks for watching. And I'll see you when I see you. It's probably going to be the post office videos next. I think it's going to be a two-parter though, because it's only a very short thing. It's, I've forgotten her first name now, but her last name's Staple. Very stationary. Silly. Thanks for watching. Bye.